Welcome to another unit in this Excel course. This time I'm going to talk about the two functions FV and PV, which basically stand for final or future value and present value. Well, present and future value of what? So imagine you're having a savings account and each period you want to pay the same amount of money into this savings account. And then you want to know either what is the final value of this savings account, so how much money do you have saved up in a certain amount of periods, or if you want to compare this to a one-off payment, so one single payment by the beginning of the periods, how high would this single payment have to be to achieve the same outcome? That would be then the present value. The final value, the end value of this savings plan, would be F. So let's have a look how we can actually calculate them. Let's start with the FV. So here we start FV. Then he wants to have a rate, which means the interest rate per period. He wants to have an NPER, the number of periods. The payment I actually pay each period. That's here the 100. And then I have two optional possibilities. I can specify an additional initial payment, so something which I have already in this savings account. Here I'm just setting this to zero, so if the savings account starts with nothing. And in the end, I can select the type of savings plan. So rather the question, is this an immediate plan where I save or conduct my payment by the end of the period? Or is this a due savings plan where the payment is conducted by the beginning of the period? Let's select here an immediate payment plan. Then this is more or less the value, the final value of this savings plan. This means if for 12 periods I save 100 euros at an interest rate of 1%, the final value of money I will have saved after this time will be 1,268.25 euros. Here, I can also add this is negative because Excel considers this as if I want to buy something like this, a plan like this, how much would this be worth by the end of the payment period? And that's why he considers this as I have to pay this amount. But if you simply interpret this without the minus, this tells you the outcome of the savings plan. Well, if we also want to know what this savings plan would be worth today, so if I want to replace the 12 payments of 100 euros each by one single payment by the beginning of all this, I can replace this with PV, with the present value. Here in this case, I start similarly with the interest rate, the number of periods, and the payment. Now I can say I have an additional value, an additional final value, which, however, in this case we assume to be zero, so we just consider the same plan as here. And finally, I can also decide, is this an immediate payment plan, so each payment happens by the end, or a due plan, each payment happening by the beginning of the period. For comparison's sake, select here zero as well, or we could also click down the lower part, click OK. So in other words, this plan which will lead to a final value of 1200 something, will have the same value as a one-off payment of 1125.51 euros if I pay this amount only once by the beginning of this payment plan. Well, that's everything then to the FV and PV. So it's more or less about the values, the final value and the present value of a payment plan. So I say goodbye and see you next time.